Salutations in the name of Jesus, and thank you for visiting the Light of Heaven. I hope you have a wonderful day in Christ. To ensure you don't miss any updates, we hope you like this movie and subscribe to our YouTube channel. Come along for the ride as you watch this film through to the very finish. The Virgin Mary gave Pope Francis a profound and unsettling message in a world full of uncertainty and gloom. This vision, which was made public at a pivotal point in human history, highlights the grave problems the world is currently facing and the pressing need for spiritual strength and prayer. Pope Francis had a vision of the Virgin Mary that was both terrible and amazing. She was described as having a radiant crown on her head and a lovely veil covering her face. She was dressed entirely in white. However, underneath her feet rested a sphere enveloped in dense black smoke, signifying the gloomy struggles the globe faces today. The Holy Mother warned that bad times are coming and that darkness is encroaching on the planet. This frightening vision is a warning to humanity to get ready for the hardships that lie ahead and to turn to prayer and religion for solace. Pope Francis, in his capacity as the Vicar of Christ, made a strong case for ardent prayer. He underlined how important it is for the Church and its priests to lead lost souls to Jesus Christ in these difficult times. In his speech, the Pope emphasized the need for steadfast faith and the effectiveness of group prayer in fending off the approaching darkness. The Virgin Mary commanded everyone to pray passionately for the Church and her clergy, according to Pope Francis. This call to prayer is not only for individual salvation, but also for the Church's unity and combined strength in the face of spiritual challenges. The Virgin Mary not only offered spiritual advice, but also emphasized the significance of bodily well-being. She notably emphasized diabetes, which affects a sizable portion of the world's population and is a silent and ubiquitous hazard. In response, the Pope expressed worry and urged people to manage their health and stop the sickness from spreading. Diabetes, which frequently goes undiagnosed until it presents serious dangers, can be controlled and even avoided with knowledge and lifestyle modifications. The Pope urged everyone to learn about the risks associated with diabetes and to look for natural ways to keep their blood sugar levels in check. Pope Francis sincerely invited everyone to return to the Church's teachings. He admitted that many people have veered off the straight and narrow path due to the lures and diversions of contemporary living. But he gave comfort, saying that the Church is always open to receiving individuals who are looking for reconciliation and forgiveness. A potent reminder of the spiritual wars being fought was provided by the image of the Virgin Mary shrouded in black smoke at the Cathedral of St. Peter in Rome. The theme is one of hope and resiliency despite the depressing picture. The Virgin Mary is said to guard the Church, leading and shielding it from those who would destroy it, the Pope emphasized. The enormous power of the Rosary was one of the main topics of the Pope's speech. Many people have strengthened their faith through the ages by wearing the Rosary, an ancient devotion that is said to be a powerful weapon against the powers of evil. In order to meditate on the mystery of Christ's life, death, and resurrection, Pope Francis urged the faithful to take up this practice. People can change their hearts, deepen their faith, and illuminate the world with Christ's light by saying the Rosary on a daily basis. When faced with hardship, the Rosary acts as a spiritual shield, providing comfort and fortitude. Pope Francis urged all followers of Christ to lead holy and selfless lives. In a world that has grown chilly and unresponsive to God's love, he urged them to be rays of hope. This is a call to action to actively participate in the mission of the Church, rather than to wait around. The Pope reminded the faithful of Mary's everlasting presence and her role as humanity's advocate before God's throne. He implored everyone, particularly in these tumultuous times, to seek her protection and counsel. Pope Francis stated that secularism, relativism, and atheism will continue to try to discredit Church teachings and divert people from God, acknowledging the mounting threats they offer. He did, however, reassure believers that they are not facing this battle alone. One constant source of strength is the Virgin Mary, who is ever present and always pleads on behalf of humanity. With its sacraments, the Bible, and the fellowship of believers, the Church continues to be a stronghold against the approaching darkness. It provides those who seek it with boundless supplies of grace and power. In the end, the Pope's message is one of optimism, reminding the faithful that Christ's light never goes out. Even in the deepest of circumstances, He urged everyone to be a beacon of this light by following Christ's teachings and making a positive impact on a world that is more compassionate and just. The Church and all of her children are covered by the sheltering mantle of the Virgin Mary during difficult and uncertain times. She leads us with her brilliant light, giving us the courage and fortitude to confront the challenges ahead by pointing us toward Jesus Christ. Pope Francis made a call for unity in prayer and sacrifice as his speech came to an end. Invoking the aid of the Holy Trinity and the Blessed Virgin Mary, he prayed for the Church and its adherents to be enveloped in her love and compassion. In a world that is in search of direction and meaning, the Pope prayed for the fortitude to follow Christ, to be authentic witnesses of the gospel, and to be vehicles of God's mercy. He exhorted the faithful to use the Rosary as their indestructible barrier against evil, and the Eucharist as their source of strength. Through prayer, particularly the recitation of the Rosary, believers can become nearer to God and discover the strength to go past any challenge. Pope Francis concluded by underlining the Virgin Mary's constant presence. Her intercession is a strong force that leads the Church and its adherents through the most trying circumstances. With order for the Pope and all other Church leaders to be able to lead Christ's flock with knowledge, bravery, and humility going forward, he begged for her blessings. The Pope made a sincere appeal for cooperation, prayer, and action in his speech. He called on all believers to unite, to pray constantly, and to lead holy and selfless lives. By doing this, individuals can contribute to creating a world that is more compassionate and just, and that reflects the light of Christ everywhere. All Christians are urged to take action by Pope Francis's plea. He urged them to live out their faith fearlessly, to remain steadfast in their adherence to Christ and his teachings, and to actively participate in the Church's mission. He reassured them that the Church will always be a source of grace, a lighthouse of hope, and a testament to God's unending love, regardless of the difficulties that lie ahead. Let us keep the Pope's words in mind as we navigate these uncertain times. Accepting the call to prayer, living a resolute life in our faith, and being beacons of hope and light in a world in dire need, let us. With the Virgin Mary's intercession, we may confront any obstacle with bravery and faith, since she is always by our side, guiding and guarding us. We appreciate your patience as you watch the entire video. What do you think about the subject of today? If you would like to be notified when a new video is released, please click the bell icon and subscribe to the channel. Thank you.